This is Mainak and you're watching Civil Bro. So in this series we're going to design a practical building G+, as you can see, ground floor, first floor and second floor. So it is G+2 building. So and we're going to design this particular building, and the entire process will be given. You can watch, it will be a long video. So first of all, we're going to start by, since this is an unsymmetrical plan, the architect has done the column positioning also. So since this is an this unsymmetrical plan, we will first find out the coordinates, and after we find out the coordinates, we will just copy those coordinates in Excel so that we can easily do that while performing all these steps in the STAAD.Pro, and obviously the detailing we'll do in RCDC software. So let's get started. First of all, I'll just save this file since I have also not done the design, and I'll save this file as my picture plan changed, because here it will contain all the coordinates. So now for holding all the coordinates, you know that the all the videos in which I do column positioning, you have to check and overlap the columns at different levels. But in this, all the column position has been done by the architect, so I'll not do that step. I'll go by the default size which has been given, and then we'll see if it needs to be changed or something else. Okay. So and we'll see here 9 inch. So yeah, we're going to probably go with 10 inches, but that's okay. So this first of all, we'll need the center line for the ground floor, first floor and second floor as well. So we'll just take the center of this particular thing and select this, and here this is the ground floor. We copy this. Can also delete all the things which are unnecessary here. This a little bit. First floor plan. The terrace plan, we just remove that, and we will bring this one. I guess this one is the same ground floor plan, so we'll leave this one, and this one we will move this one. Let's say here, and let's keep them this distance. So so this video is going to be long, and if you want to watch and do it, you can do it, or else you can just check out other videos which are shorter, but this is a project, so it will take some time, this video. I'll select similar, and yeah, these are all the dimensions, right? To update them, and this bedroom and this select similar, don't need them at all, and yep. Okay, so let's see. Now we have the vertical ones, I guess. Vertical ones are all done. So now we have the horizontal center lines. For now, okay, forgot to turn on the ortho. Take the line and then escape, and then copy. And then paste. Copy. just move them a little bit. Okay, so check out of these things don't want to. You want to keep the staircase because that would be necessary. So let's see all the primary beams here. At the plinth level, I don't think any secondary beams will be required here. So you know, I'll ignore that. Obviously, at the roof level, we'll provide secondary beams where required. But you know, the plinth level, I don't think these minor secondary beams would be required at all. So can ignore that. So yeah, I think all the primary beams have their you know, things done, and yeah, so I'll also, you know, just open the original plan here just to, you know, check whether original one, just to check whether this is a floor or not. So this is, I'm just wondering what is this. I think this is just a veranda or something, so we will not need any columns. So we'll go with that. And this staircase also, this will be a brick staircase. So this is also not required. Anything is not required here. So this portion and yeah, and this portion also can be deleted. Not relevant for the structural point of view, but you know, since there is a column here, so there will be beams here. So yeah, we'll delete this. So this is the case, and the back also we have staircase. This will be also brick staircase, not required for the structural point of view. Okay. So this is it. This is the plan. I think I have just considered all the primary beams, and also while doing so I have sorted out something. So I'll take a text here, and here it will be my 0, 0. I hope the text setting is done here. Okay, yeah, perfect. Size is perfect. So the 0, 0, and we'll start as of this. So copy to do this one, and I'll take a dimension here, and we'll take a dimension here. Okay, so what I could do is convert this into like meter, and then just do it, or else I can directly write the value in meter here directly, you know, just to avoid that extra step also. I can do it. Okay, or else I can convert it into meter. That would actually save a lot of time, I think. So what I'll do, I'll convert this into meter later. Okay. So I'll also delete this text for now, and let's go complete the center line in this particular drawing, and then we'll later see. So line has been taken, and this one center line is tricky. Let's just give it along here. Okay. So it depends on the size of the beam what the actual center line will be, but just for approximate one, I'm taking this. Okay. And I think it is better if I take my center line on a particular layer here. If there is a layer called let's say layer 3. I'll keep it layer 3, everything. Green is okay, I think. Layer 3. Layers. is okay. So this is done, and then this is done here. So this is done, and let's see if we need any so-called secondary beams here. Actually, there are a lot of things which are not in the primary zones here. I think the layer properties, this green color, I think I need to change this. I'll go with it's better if I go with this one here, not this one. This is better. So we'll close that here and we'll continue. So yeah, some secondary beams need to be added here. So we have to decide on which secondary beams which we need to give. Obviously, I'll not consider this portion, this thing. I do have to consider this. It's a considerable size of wall and 16 feet wall. So it has to go. Beam has to go here. And there is no other way. And same for this case, 16 feet long wall will put considerable load on the slab, so you know, I cannot ignore this particular portion. And copy this to this portion, and also this, let me see the distance of the wall. It is 10 feet again, so it cannot be ignored, right? There are too many beams, I could have ignored this. Yes, yeah. But in this case, it cannot be ignored. So this, there is a small beam here, a small beam here, and obviously, and another secondary beam is in here apparently. Anyway. Direction we can give. So just a bit, little bit. Okay. So again, you just check whether any secondary beam has been missing or not. Okay. So we check the architectural plan original. So whether they are given a cutout here. It looks like area double heighted. Okay, so it's double heighted area, but I think that it is a cutout or something, like it is a double heighted area. So we clarified that it's actually a slab, you know, that there will be no slab in the first floor, and there will be a slab in the second floor. So here we have to give a beam, obviously, because there is a cutout portion here. only particularly in this level. Okay, so we have to give this. So there we go, and this is done. I will check whether any other secondary beams are remaining here. I think we have provided the secondary beams for all the cases. Now we will proceed to the next floor, which is the second floor. And second floor, you can see there is no cutout here in the second floor. So we will be good to go. So let's first of all, let me just copy for the primary beams, because the primary beams will remain the same, right? Both the horizontal and the vertical ones, and it will be the same. So we'll just copy this for the primary beams, and we will paste them. And okay, yeah, and then there will be the same for the balcony also. So balcony portion beams also, center line also, we'll just copy them. And yeah, there is no primary beams here, so this we will copy. And then take a common point, that is the center line. We'll take this center line. This is the center line of this here, and we will paste it in this center. So I can see the primary beams have been pasted, and in the terrace floor as well. I think there will not be any secondary beam. There shouldn't be. But still, we'll check. And the terrace portion that I'm speaking about, and we will do the same for the terrace as well. So primary beams have been copied to the next two levels, and then just trim the remaining parts as well. No need to be much exaggerated. So this is the case, and now let's look for secondary beams. First we'll go vertical and look if there is any vertical secondary beam which you need to give. And obviously we have one here and another one here, and we don't have anything else. I guess this one we can ignore. This is a small portion, so we'll ignore this. And yeah, this is also ignorable. This is a small, very small portion. This half of the portion will be in the contention for the primary beam. So just go here like this. And, I think I missed it here as well, right? Since I have matched it there, and just extend it to be of uniform length, right? Here it is okay, I think. Here it is, and because I didn't copy from there, so here it is okay, no problem. Here it has been corrected, and this one I didn't copy, so I'll just copy it now. This is it actually. This is done, and this location is a little bit strange for me. It would be better if we gave it in a particular direction flush. So this either in this direction, but I guess this is done for space. So I have to take care of it. Just be careful during when I make the center line diagram. So that would be of importance. Just extend this things. Okay, and this one also needs to be extended, because I'll ultimately find out the coordinates. So when you want the coordinates, you want. We want everything to go on, right? So here, let's see it. There is a secondary point here which you need to give. I think this is in the same line, right? Okay, this is in the same line, so no problem. And what is this portion? Sitting area and steps. I don't think that anything else will be structural will be there. So just this is of no significance here. And this portion will ignore. But let me see, what is this? Okay, there is a toilet here. So full wall has been given, so unfortunately I have to add up there secondary beam. Okay, move it. So let's write the coordinates here. Let's go for text. Okay, before going for the coordinates, let's check whether everything is done or not. Since everything is done, then we'll go for the change. Okay, so I'm going to go and create a new file. F7 to remove the grid. You can enter for the units here and. Let's go precision of 000 and the unit will be meters. So we'll select meters from here and click on OK and click on annotate, and this text will define a text here. We'll define new and T100 and this will be 0.15 meter and apply set current and close. And in the dimensions, let us define a new dimension style. And first of all, I'll go to the text and select the text which you just defined. Primary units decimal and obviously 3 places of accuracy. And then you have symbols and arrows. This arrow size 0.15. And this is it. Okay. And set current and close. So I will save this drawing, and we will save this drawing as the center line meter. Save. So and we will draw a 9-inch wall. So if you have, you know, conversion, 9-inch line will draw 9-inch into 925.4. It's actually 228.6 mm, or in meter can go 0.229. So we'll take a line here and enter, and ortho on, this will be 0.229. so this is the line actually which we are talking about, 0.229. you see the dimension also. So this, go to this architectural plan, we'll just copy this, Ctrl plus C, and then in this portion Ctrl plus B, we'll just paste it. Okay, I think it's pasting has not been done. Try again, select the thing, this thing, Ctrl plus C, and in this control plus P, paste it here. Let me delete this and just try it. Oh, this was pasted earlier, sorry. Okay, earlier when first step only this was done, so no problem. I'll just move it here. Okay, let me move it downwards only because otherwise there might be some problems. This one. So we'll select the entire drawing. Entire drawing selected, and only this portion is selected. Okay, this line, and we'll use A, L, Enter. Now let's change this. You can see in the original drawing this is actually 9 inches, right? So in this okay, I can do it again. Actually Ctrl plus A and then shift and deselect this. After this is deselected, then A L Enter. First source point, and well, this is too small, so I have to keep it at a particular position so that I remember. Let me keep it in. Directly below it, so Ctrl plus A, shift and deselect this, A L Enter, first source point, second first destination point, second source point, second destination point, Enter, yes. So this is scaling is done. You can check whether it is 0.229 or not. That's 0.229 and everything has been scaled. Now we can easily do the you know, the coordinate marking. So let's go forward with the coordinates. We will just go for the text here, and we'll go forward and give it 0.0. Copy this and keep the dimension here. It's a 4.898. And then next one. Okay, so next coordinate, let's give them 1, 2, and 3, and this will have the same x coordinate but only the y coordinate will change. So let's take another dimension line for noting the y coordinate. Let's see, this is 4.86, so I'm just 4.86, copy that, Ctrl C, and then paste them in all the places where you have the y coordinates. See if I have missed anything here. Missed anything in the plinth level? I have only given the primary beam, so it's okay. All good to go. Then we take it to the next level, copy them, and take to the next level. Only in this case, also the y coordinate needs to be changed. So let's see what is the y coordinate there. So it is 6.972. So here we go, 6.972. And copy that like this and Ctrl plus C, and then we'll paste it in the remaining places like that. So once you've done that, let's move on to the next coordinate portion. There won't be any beam coming here like this, so there will be only this particular point which can be copied, and the y coordinate, let's move on to the next point, the next grid line, and this one will copy, and let's do the x coordinates also. So the y coordinate is 9.885, so write it here, double click and just change it. 9.885 is the y coordinate, and then we'll what we'll do, we'll copy this to this two portions, and we'll write that coordinate from here. This is actually 16.882, and we'll just mention here 16.882. And the next one is, let's see, next one is 21.284. So mention here we have 21.284. This is it, and then we want to copy this once again and paste it here, and again just change the y coordinate to the next level, and yeah, we'll have more actually. This two also will go up, and the y coordinate needs to be changed. X coordinate is defined for all, so no need to change the x coordinate. 11.704 is the y coordinate, so we'll write here 11.704. Here also, right, paste it here, okay, this is done. So the next point is only the change of the y coordinate. Once again, there are no new ones. Actually, eventually we have a new one that is a column, that is a new column position, so we will have that. Let's do the things first. Y coordinate change first, okay. So this is 17.150, click and just write it 17.150 and copy, control plus C, and then paste it. What is this? X coordinate, it is 8.257. So I'm going to write here 8.257. So that's the coordinate setup done and completed for the ground floor. So now let's look at the next floor, which is the first floor. So obviously we'll copy the positions where we have the primary beams, that in this case is all the coordinates where we have the primary beams, we'll copy them, sorry, the columns especially, and the primary beams will be the same, all the beams passing through a column connected by columns are primary, considered as fixed connections in the building, you know that. So all of this, these gets copied onto this here, and I can copy it to the next two levels also, it will be easier for me, I think. Okay, I can, what I can do, right click and select similar, this one, and deselect this, and then I can copy it to the, but these are not in the same level, right? Let me just check whether these are in the same level or not. This is in the same level, right? So I can bring these two at the same level as well. I'll move it from here to here. And I'll move that from there to there. So now these are at the same level. And so once these are at the same level, now I can easily copy. I'll just select one of the text and right click, select similar. And shift and deselect this. And then I'll copy from here to here, and then here to here. So once this is copied, now this portion has been copied. Now let's look into this further parts. So we will, this x coordinate will remain the same, and we'll have changes in the y coordinate here, 1, 2, and 3. Let's give it for the balcony portion. And this is linear, so it is 1.628, so I'll give it minus 1.628. And just copy them and paste it here. Changed, and we'll go to the next part. We have a coordinate here as well, actually, so we have to mention that as well. X coordinate changed here, actually. So let's see. So 1.59, it's minus 1.59 and 0. So we want these two coordinates. Copy and go here. This level we don't have any other beam, so 4.084 is the column. 4.084, and we'll copy this, control plus C, and then simply paste it here, control plus V, and then the next portion. I don't think, yeah. Just thought so. We have a secondary beam, and this beam that don't want to extend, the next beam I want to extend here. So what I'll do, the primary beams obviously I want to extend for the balcony. This one will extend 1.59, it will be 4.86, right? The y coordinate. So 4.86, this is given, and let's do it for all, right? And this is 6.972. Okay, and the next column 11.704. I can just copy this y coordinate, not, and paste it here. Last time I'm doing this, this is 17.15. Okay, so this is done in this portion. Okay, and then the bottom portion also I did. So now let's go line by line. This line is over. Next line of columns. This is over. And to move on to the next one, obviously this is this. So this, extend this a bit, okay. Just for the ease of doing business. And this is 6. And how many amount of beams do we have here? Okay, we have not done this yet because we have a beam here for the cutout portion, so we have to define that. So this is the x coordinate which you need to find out. So distill that better. So this is it. 7.309 is this coordinate. Done. This line is done binary now. So now this and this are not extended to the balcony portion. So keep it that way. And the y coordinate 6.056. Copy and then you just paste it here. This going up to this much and copy this. Only the y coordinate needs to be changed, and you already have this 9.266. This one also, we have the x coordinate. Y coordinate we need to change, and this is take a little bit up just in case. So this is for the cutout. We have to give a beam here for the cutout portion, and this is defined. I think this line has been done, and for the next line, you can see this is the next line here. This is also quite done, and I can move up, I think, for the Y at least. We move up and provide the secondary beam for this one, and this one can be X coordinate already know. So this needs to go, copy this up and copy this down. Yeah, this will be the x coordinate, and for the y coordinate we have the 12.805. So just 12.805, and let's copy this, Ctrl plus C, and let's double click here and paste it here. So this is it, and these two coordinates remain there, and there, this and this is it, 14.926, and it is 14.926. So copy this. Just do it along this, and then once we have done this, and let's check for any other secondary beams here. No, I think we are pretty much done. Yeah, this one is remaining. Yeah, how did you miss this? This one is remaining. We also don't have the x coordinate of this as well. So x coordinate is 12.608. about this. Okay, I have missed around, sorry. This is x coordinate, this should be here, and the y coordinate is this one, should be here. This portion done, and this is also done. So this all this stuff has been done, and we can move on to the next portion, which is the terrace slope. And let's see, and we can eventually copy the coordinates of the balcony. This is the reference point. Okay, this is not actually the balcony. This is actually the second floor. Okay, still we can copy the coordinates of the balcony. This is the terrace. So let's first ground floor done, first floor done, and let's move on to the second floor. So let's dive ahead. This line complete, this line seems complete, this line also seems complete, and this line, well, we have a secondary beam, I guess. Is this in the same line as this beam? It's kind of, yeah, it's kind of in the same line. This is actually in the same line as this beam, so yeah, we're going to copy this also. This is the same line, and let's see. This is definitely not in the same line as any of the beam. This portion has been done, and this portion done, this portion done, yeah. This portion is remaining. Let's take the coordinate of this y coordinate from 0. And we need this one. We need, we need a new x. Yes, or we have the x. This coordinate. We don't have, right? So the y coordinate is 13.626. Let's change that first. X coordinate is 3.975, y coordinate is 17.15, and this thing is done here. But in this y coordinate, we have some cases because this beam will have the intersection, so I have to give this coordinate as well. I have to give this coordinate, and I have to give this coordinate as well. All this y coordinate I need to change, this coordinate as well. I need to give, and for this one we want to give. If we want to give, then we need to give this one also, and yeah, let's, I don't know this one. This one x coordinate also needs to be changed. X, this one, this is not known. So first of all, let me change the y coordinate 13.3626. So let's change the y coordinate first. This one's x coordinate also needs to be changed. And this is the actually the center line 12.608. Yes, 12.608 is the answer, and then copy this. And it is 17.15 here. So these are the cases which we are having, and hopefully just briefly check whether any of the beams, locations where beams will be there or intersections will be there, are being missed. I think as of now there is no such portions, so we'll move on to the next thing, right? So these have the same coordinate, so yeah, we use this, and this is not required. Main beam this, and again main beam, yeah, this will obviously be required, and main beam this is required. This one will ignore. Okay. So copy and paste it. So these three have been copied. This one, I'll ignore this. This is portion, and yeah, I think this one is should also be the same. So these two needs to be copied. So copy and paste this, and we have the coordinates of the terrace. Let's check whether anything is missing here. So everything is kind of okay as of now. Ground floor, first floor, second floor, and this terrace portion or the roof of the second floor, you can say these coordinates are done. The next thing is to write these coordinates in Excel, and after that we will do the design in STAAD, all the process in STAAD.